राजा साहब बोल रहे थे क्यों खड़े नहीं हुए, उन्होंने काफी सारी बातें की और रूल्स के हिसाब से नहीं, हम आराम से सुनते रहे, सुनने की भी आदत डाली ओवरसी साहब, इस तरह से नहीं चलेगा, सुनना पड़ेगा।
ऑफिसर एंड यू से हियर दैट आवर लॉज विल प्रिवेल, इट विल नॉट प्रिवेल बिकॉज द लोकल लॉज विल प्रिवेल। What powers are you giving to that NIU officer? For example, something happens, God forbid, in Afghanistan, you know, it happened in the Indian embassy. Will the Afghans allow it? No. Even Nepal will not allow you. The reason behind is that, do we have that diplomatic clout? Please don't compare ourselves with US and Israel. You know, these are not, in true sense, democratic countries, sir. Thirdly, sir, this is my opinion. No. Are you so afraid of US? You love US so much. Good luck to you and Israel. I don't. Madam, sir, now here, amendment to section, it talks about affecting the interests of India. What is that? Can you please define what is affecting the interests of India? You know, in bill, it cannot be so vague. Third point, sir. Now, you say this affecting the interests of India, you are creating a device for yourself to even bring in some people who write a blog against your ideology and your party, sir. Fourthly, sir, now, you in this bill, you say special court designated for an area or areas. Again, this is, you are attracting Article 14, this is violating Article 14 of the Constitution, sir, because the notification has to be made. And you cannot make for some specific case or areas. It is violative of equality provision. Why I say that, please read Anwar Ali Sarkar and the state of West Bengal, sir. Fourth point, sir. Does the NIA have special investigative techniques? And if those investigative techniques, do they have the legislative approval and sanction? No. And sir, two 3 minutes, sir, Khali. 2 minutes, DJ khatam kar dunga, sir. Sir, now, in administration, in administrative and constitutional law, sir, we follow the rule that any power is coupled with the responsibility. May I know from the Honourable Minister, now what is the responsibility of his government towards the victims? I can quote you numerous examples. Samjhota Blast, the judge said that the NIA could not even produce the CCTV footage of the Delhi railway station. Can I know from the Honourable Minister that will his government issue a letter of apology to the Malegaon 1 accused who were exonerated by courts of law? I want to know from the Honourable Minister, sir, you are in the schedule, you have included IT Act. Can he confirm to this house that the ISIS in Khorasa had issued a video with my photograph stating that I am a ghulam of this Hindu nation? Whether that video is there or not, please say that. The reason I am saying is that, because the Honorable Minister quoted, and that's a khatam karo, sir. The answer, aap me rescue kaiye, sir. Honorable Minister stated that Hyderabad is a den of terrorists. The ISIS in Khorasan issued a video with my photograph. So what am I? Am I for the nation or am I for the terrorists? Let the government reply to that. You know, or the nation. Sir, will you appeal against the Makkah Masjid blast? Who killed those 9 people? Which included a 11-year-old Hafiz of Quran. I had seen his body, his head was in 2 pieces. I cannot still go to his house. Why are you not appealing? Do you have a firm resolve against terrorism? Why are you not appealing against the Makkah Masjid blast? Who's responsible? Where's accountability? Who's responsible for 66 people who died in Samjhota blast? Why are you not appealing? Why are you not appealing? Why are you not appealing against Ajmer blast? So these are all terrorist offenses. And I hope that the government will reply to it. Because you see, the narrative, sir, khatam kar, narrative kya ho gaya, sir? Ke victim agar Musalman hai, aur accused non-Muslim hai, to aap kuch nahi karenge. Sir,
Nishikant sir.